Ah, the eternal pursuit of happiness, or in this case, subscribers. We all work damn hard to produce amazing content to convince our viewers to become subscribers and join the community, much like you can do right now here at vidIQ. However, what if I told you there was a built-in YouTube tool that, if used correctly, can increase your subscriber count from that source by 500%, and it only takes 20 seconds? It's on screen right now, and I'm going to show you how to do it. Let's do this.
VidIQ.
VidIQ.com.
You know, one of these days I'm probably going to damage this lens irreparably, but until then, it's going to get the old rough treatment. Hello folks, welcome to vidIQ. My name is Rob. If this is your first time in these glorious YouTube surroundings, we are indeed the YouTube tool and channel that aims to help you get more views in less time by educating you on your YouTube journey. Now, of course, the vidIQ Chrome extension is free to download. A link is in the description, and it's crammed full of awesome tools, including our legendary video scorecard, keyword research, and the recently upgraded channel audit tool, which if you press on it, it's gonna make your jaw drop. Wow. However, what we want to talk to you today about is a very simple tool from YouTube that's been around for a considerable amount of time, but when used in the right fashion, can give you so many more subscribers per video. It sits on every video and it allows any user on any device to use it. I'm just gonna check my viewfinder now. I'm gonna point to it around about there. It is your YouTube watermark branding, and it allows a user to mouse over it or to tap on it on a mobile device and subscribe directly to your channel without leaving the page or having to navigate off the video itself. Now, a lot of video creators simply use their logo or a channel avatar that doesn't strictly ask the viewer to subscribe to their channel. And since this is a call to action to subscribe to your channel, it should do that in its very essence. So I'm gonna show you what we use on our channel, how to set it up, and what impact it can have. Let's jump on a computer and take a look. On any screen of the new YouTube layout, you should see your channel icon in the top right-hand corner. If you click on that, you'll have the option to go to your Creator Studio. Bear in mind, at this time of recording, you need to go to the classic version of your Creator Studio. Once you're in the Creator Studio, down the left side navigation panel, there's plenty of options. What you want to choose today is channel, and then once it's refreshed the page, there should be some new subheadings. One of them is branding. Click on that, and it will take you to your YouTube branding watermark. If you haven't added a watermark before, the screen's going to look like this. So obviously you want to click on add a watermark, and it will give you some general guidelines. When you finish reading them, click on choose file, and this is where you can select your branded watermark that's going to appear on your YouTube videos. So the next big question is, what watermark should you use? And we suggest something like this, a red play button with the word subscribe on it. There are a few reasons for this. First of all, the watermark brand is a square shape and you want to fit as much of that shape as possible with a box that looks like this. Secondly, it fits the design style of YouTube, and anything that looks like it should be naturally placed on a YouTube page is more likely to be clicked. And finally, it needs to be clear, simple, and explicit, and it does exactly what it says on the tin, essentially. And because we're such generous people, we're going to provide you with this exact branding watermark. There is a link in the description. Download it right now. Once you've decided on your watermark, it will show you a preview of what it's going to look like, and when you click save, that's going to apply your watermark to every single video on your YouTube channel. Now, there's one more thing you'll want to do before leaving the screen, and that's to change the display time of the watermark. Change it from custom start time to entire video to ensure that whenever somebody is watching one of your videos, they see that watermark branding. The argument being that every single viewer's watching habits are different, and it could be 2 minutes into the video, 8 minutes into the video, or at the very start of a video that they decide to subscribe to your channel. And you want to give them every opportunity to do that, and the watermark branding is one of the best ways to grab that subscriber. And there you are, folks, a ready-made, fresh, out-of-the-oven, branded YouTube watermark. But we know you're a fickle bunch out there. What if you don't like this? What if you would prefer something that's more suited to the colour scheme of your channel? Well, the answer to that is to create your own. You can do it for free, takes around 5 minutes, and you can do it online right now. We'll show you how. All you need to do is point your browser to the following uber powerful online graphic design tool, which is www.canva.com. It is free to use, you just need to create an account. As you can see, I've already created a masterpiece of a watermark down here, but we're going to go through the process step by step so you can get one set up for your channel too. In the top right of the screen, there should be a use custom dimensions button. Click that and then set the dimensions to 400 by 400. That should give you a plain white box that looks something like this. And the first thing you want to add to this box is a background. There are tools on the left hand side. Choose background and choose your color scheme. Obviously for vidIQ, we want blue. A simple triangle is going to represent the play button here on the watermark. To get that, go to elements, then click on shapes and find the triangle. When you click on that, it will automatically add the shape to your square box, but it's likely going to be the wrong color and wrong orientation. To fix this, you'll see a black color box in the top left of the main canvas. This is the color of your shape. Simply click on it and switch it to white. And then on the shape itself, you'll see a rotation icon at the bottom of the shape. Click and drag that to get it to face the right way. Now, as per usual, this is where you can get to IKEA levels of positioning, where you're constantly resizing the shape and putting it in the right place. But once you've done that, the next thing you'll want to do is add some text. You'll find that tool again on the left-hand side. Click there, then add a heading. Now, this text again will be in the wrong color and the wrong font. There are all sorts of fonts you can choose. In this particular example, we chose Illyrian Heavy, but you can scroll through all of the fonts and see which suits your design. And the font size will need adjusting as well, so it fits nicely under your play button. And don't forget to change your font color unless black suits your color scheme. Once your masterpiece is complete, there is a download button in the top right hand corner. Click that, followed by the green download button, and that will allow you to save the watermark directly to your computer. To replace an existing watermark, you first have to remove it and start from scratch, as you saw earlier on in this video. And the end result is something that looks like this. To be honest, we prefer our original YouTube watermark branding button, so we're going to switch back to that. So you should all now have the branding watermarks of your choice, and as you can see, it's a relatively simple thing to do, but I wanted to go through it step by step just to make sure you get exactly what you need. Now for the good stuff. You've set up this watermark, people are clicking on it, subscribing to your content. How do you find out how successful that watermark is? That's where we need to jump into the analytics. Take a look at this. In the YouTube Creator Studio, you want to go to the analytics section and scroll all the way down until you find annotations. Now in this section, you want to click on annotation type, a box just below the graph, and then choose branding watermark. And this will show you all the click-throughs for your branded watermark on all of your videos for your channel. This is where we finally get to see the payoff of this relatively simple piece of work. When we change our analytics to 2018, you're going to notice a significant shift in our data. Exactly when we added this branded watermark for the entire duration of all our videos. Now, you should know by now that I love digging into the analytics, and when we look at our previous watermark, which was a thin red subscribe strip that started 45 seconds into a video, we get 3, 2, maybe even just 1 click a day. When we change it to this box for the whole duration of the video, we're talking 15, 16, 17 clicks, and it's now increased to above 20 every single day. And if you need further evidence, we tried exactly the same thing on a second channel, and although the results weren't quite as pronounced, as you can see, there was an increase in click-through rate on the subscribe branding watermark. So if you haven't been using a YouTube branded watermark, shame on you. Now you have absolutely no excuse. You can see the benefits of it. Go set one up. Follow this guide. If you have been using a branded watermark and you don't feel as if you've been getting any results from it, try ours for at least 28 days and then come back to us and let us know how you get on. Now, if you enjoyed this video, we've got plenty more on YouTube tools over here. There's one on YouTube hashtags in 2018. And if you want to know how much YouTube you're watching every single day, we've got a detailed guide down here. We'll see you on either of those videos right now. Enjoy the rest of your video making day.